A new round of hefty oil price increases sparks opposition. Multisectoral groups held a protest in Quezon City to appeal for immediate government action addressing rising oil prices. Transport groups also saying the recent 1 peso fare hike for jeepneys was just negated by latest price adjustments, which took effect today. Diesel prices saw the biggest increase of nearly 7 pesos.
Kasunod po nito ay ang pagtaas ng presyo ng bilihin. Kung mapapansin natin, yung mga nagdaang mga linggo ay nagbababa sila ng halos tatlong magkakasunod na linggo. Isang taas lang nila, bawi kagad yung yung ginabaan nila. Kaya kung titignan mo, kahit may tagdag pamasahe, ay mawawalan din sa isa yung mga tagdag na pamasahe at talagang matataasapin yung mga bilihin.
Meanwhile, the Energy Department not discounting the possibility of diesel prices reaching over 100 pesos per liter. The agency says that projection may be the effect of the decision of the Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries to cut its production by 2 million barrels per day. Director Rino Abad of the DOE's Oil Industry Management Bureau adds, the weakening of the peso versus the U.S. dollar is also contributing to the increase of oil prices.
The Philippine government assures the public it is considering its options to address rising oil prices. This is after transport groups called for a 3 to 4 month suspension of the fuel excise tax. Malacanang adds the government is reviving the oil drilling operations of Nido Petroleum Philippines.
Itong Kadlao oil field sa Palawan ay marirevive ang kanilang drilling operation at pinapakita lang nito ang commitment ng Pangulo na maghanap ng mga locally sourced oil products or oil exploration projects para matugunan yung pagtaas ng presyo ng langis.
Two activists were arrested in a Quezon City court after being arraigned on separate charges, which they insist are fabricated. Zian Ambrosio reports.
Labor activist Cara Tagawa and transport leader Larry Valbuena were getting ready to post bail Monday morning, October 10th, for the case of direct assault filed by policemen in July 2020. But they were caught by surprise when the Quezon City Police arrested them right there at the court. According to Attorney Armando Chidoro, the counsel of Tagawa and Valbuena, they just attended their arraignment for the case of robbery at the Quezon City RTC. They were just looking for the court where they will post bail at the MTC, but the police didn't even give them a chance.
Wrong harassment dito, no?
Bakit harassment, sir?
They are from the court and inside the Hall of Justice, no? So ibig sabihin, andun sila, may poproseso nila. Hindi sila fugitive, no? Ang dami nating totoong kriminal na naglipa na, hindi yung pinaghuhuli nila, no?
According to Attorney Chidoro, the case stemmed from a complaint by some policemen from QCPD against Tagawa and Valbuena for direct assault and robbery. Based on the complaint of 6 policemen from QCPD last July 2020, they claimed they were beaten up by the said activists and who also stole a gun from one of their policemen wearing civilian clothes. This all happened as they were mobilizing for their rally against the anti-terror law in the compound of the Commission on Human Rights. Members of the League of Filipino Students, or LFS, chaired by Tagawa, and the group Piston, where Valbuena was also one of the members.
It's abuse. That's abuse. No, that's abuse. Abuse of discretion.
Ang warrant ay December 2021 pa. Hinahanap namin sila sa mga panahong yun. They would have posted bail in those period. Ano na ngayon? 10 months na ang nakalilipas. Harassment ba yung i-implement namin ang kautusan ng isang korte?
Tagawa and Valbuena went through the booking process at Camp Caringal. Their council is already preparing all the remaining requirements, including the bail worth 36,000 pesos for their possible release on the case of direct assault. Prior to this, they have already posted bail for the case of robbery. Z. Ana Brosio, ABS-CBN News.
Red tagging is part of democracy. That bold statement coming from Philippine Justice Secretary Boying Remulla. Speaking before the United Nations Human Rights Committee in Geneva, Remulla said red tagging is merely a form of criticism on anyone who commits criminal acts. He cited the New People's Army as an example, which he claimed has killed thousands of policemen and soldiers. Various groups have called for a stop to the Philippine government's red tagging efforts, saying it has led to the killing of activists and human rights defenders.
Meanwhile, Justice Secretary Remulla says the prosecution of those involved in extrajudicial killings during the Duterte administration's drug war is among his agency's priorities. Remulla says the Justice Department has strengthened the witness protection program to encourage families of victims, witnesses, and civil society organizations to come forward. The Philippine delegation to the UN Rights Council also reiterated the Marcos administration has refocused the drug war to ensure there is strong adherence to the rule of law and human rights are respected.